Henry Guisa, Professor Henry Guisa. I'm the current chairman of the African Agribusiness Incubators Network, but I also teach entrepreneurship at the Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology. In entrepreneurship, the core aspect is innovation, creativity and innovation. And we have a specific technique for teaching our students on technology, innovation, creativity. This technique is called Scamba. As you can see, Scamba is a word, but every letter of that word brings in a method of creativity, a method of innovativeness. We know that innovation basically means improving on an existing gadget, adding value to an existing gadget. So, in front of me here, you can see some of the products of my students having used the Scamba method to generate innovations. This one, for example, you can see they have used the C in Scamba combination. This student combined a single shoe with a top, which makes it a gumboot. He has combined the normal shoes and a boot, and therefore, when pulled, it becomes a gumboot or a boot, a shoe boot. Here we can see these are necklaces. These necklaces are actually made out of waste paper. So we're going to put to other use. We are putting to another use waste paper, newspaper that we read. Students have come up with this using the Scamba method. You can see the same here. This is again out of paper using the Scamba put to other use. You can see these portraits. These portraits are also produced out of the same. This is liga. This is coffee liga. It comes from our incubator in Uganda. We find that many farmers of coffee struggle sending the coffee beans for auctioning to London, to wherever, but adding value to the coffee so that it could even be more valuable is what this incubator from Uganda, it's called Churat, has done. This is a banana products. From the banana tree, we can make these folders, we can make these gadgets. This is done in, again, our incubator in Uganda, after banana products, so that the normal banana tree is not just used for the fruits to eat the fruits, but the leaves of the banana, the stem of the banana, can be used for many, many purposes, including lampshades. This is also from the banana leaves. This is supposed to be a local rural tree. A student used a lot of waste. All this you see is waste. This basket is waste. This top here, inside it is stuffed with waste, polythene paper, with any little paper that that goes to waste has been converted. So again, we are adapting, we are putting to other use. You get this gadget, you cook your food, you put in here and cover it. It stays warm. It's very ideal for students. Students can cook in the morning, put in there, go, and when it's lunchtime, the rush has come to eat their warm food rather than cooking again. Down here, you can see this is like a table, a children's table, complete with the drawers. It has wheels. However, it's adjustable. You can remove the top part, and when you remove the top part, this inside one you can lift, and then it becomes a gadget, if you have someone who needs scratches, You can use it to guide their movement. Down there, it's you store your books. So students, I mean parents, will use it as a table, as a children's table, but at the same time, teaching the children how to walk using the same. This table that you see here, unfortunately, I cannot adjust it. It's a multi-purpose table. As it is now, you can see it's a table. But when you tilt it, it becomes an architectural drawing table. When you lift it up and then flatten it, or rather make it right on the wall, it becomes a screen where you can now project, like we are projecting here. This is also students combining different modes of tables into one, and this all comes from this method of Scamper, substituting, combining, adapting, modifying. It's a powerful technique for innovation, and as I say, innovation simply means looking at an existing gadget and seeing how to improve it, how to make it better. It is good for entrepreneurship in that an existing gadget does already have a market. So when you modify it, you are just penetrating into that market even deeper. But when you come up with a completely new thing, the difficulty of advertising and so on are there. So this is a method that I use, and I have gotten lots of good feedback from my students, and it works. I wish all of us teaching in technology and innovation and entrepreneurship could adopt this Scamper method and use it productively. Thank you very much.